Hi students, welcome in chemistry classes. And here we are studying about a very important name reaction, that is Favorsky rearrangement. Okay, what is it? Firstly understand. If we have alpha haloketones and when they are treated with the alkoxides, it means OR minus ions, then we are getting the esters, corresponding esters with the changed skeleton, it means rearranged skeleton. Okay, so the conversion of alpha haloketones to the corresponding esters with the rearranged carbon skeleton in the presence of alkoxides is known as Favorsky rearrangement. And one of the example for this is this one, C6H5CH2, C double bond O, CH2Cl. So for this reaction, there should be the alpha hydrogen should be present, and this is alpha haloketone. Why? Because you can see this is the carbonyl carbon atom and this is the alpha position, and at the alpha position there is chlorine present. Okay, so this is known as alpha haloketone, and here is these, you can say these are the alpha hydrogens that are available here. So this can undergo the Favorsky rearrangement. Okay, so in the presence of OR minus ions, this will undergo the Favorsky rearrangement, and as a result we are getting C6H5CH2CH2, C double bond O, and here what we are getting? OR. Okay, it means ester with the modified skeleton. Okay, and this reaction is also given by the cyclic alpha haloketones. But in this case, there will be the ring contraction. Okay, so see here the example. If we have given a ketone in this way, and when it is treated with NaOCH3, then what will happen here? This is a 6-membered ring. Okay, so now it will contract to the 5-membered ring, and we are getting an ester with the 5-membered ring. Okay, the number of carbon atoms remains as it is, so these are 5 atoms, and again this will be the last one, and this is OCH3. Okay, so one of the carbon atom from here is transferred at this position. Okay, and this is the carbon atom of this OCH3. Okay, and this is the hydrogen, right? Now see one more example. If the same ketone is now we treating with the OR minus ions, then what we are getting? Both are the same type of reactions. Just you see here, there is NaOCH3, this is alkoxide ion, any other ion. Okay, so we are getting here COOR. In this way the reaction is happening. Alright, now we have to see the mechanism of this reaction. How this reaction proceeds? So I have taken here the cyclic ketone. Okay, this is the chlorine at the alpha position, and at this alpha position there is hydrogen present. Okay, now we are doing the numbering 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay, so now what is happening here? In the presence of OR minus ions, this will act as the nucleophile, so it will make a nucleophilic attack at this position. Okay, so this will abstract this hydrogen. Okay, so there is the abstraction of hydrogen by this base. Okay, so now what is happening? This hydrogen is being abstracted by the base, so we are getting here a carbon ion. Okay, and this is our chlorine. Now this is the negatively charged. Okay, and here this carbon atom will be slightly positively charged. Why? Because there is a electronegative chlorine present, so this can make an attack at this carbon atom in this way, right? So there will be the expulsion of this chlorine. Okay, so this chlorine will now leave out, we can write in this way. Okay, so there is a new bond formation between this carbon atom and this one in this way, right? And this is our keto group. Okay, So this type of transient cyclopropane ring is now formed. Now in the next step, this ring is being attacked by this OR minus ion. Where this will attack? This will attack at this carbon atom of the carbonyl group, okay? And this bond will now polarize in this way. So it will have now negative charge, and there will be this will be OR group, right? So now there will be the breakage of the bond adjacent to this carbon atom. It means there are two bonds. One bond is this one. If we have numbered 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, then there may be breakage of this 1, 2 bond or this 1, 6 bond. So if we are breaking the 1, 2 bond, if we are breaking this bond, okay. So what we are getting? We are getting here COOR group. In this way, so this will be our product. But if we are breaking the 1,3 bond, 1,6 bond, okay, this is the 1,6 bond. If we are breaking this bond, this one, okay, so what we are getting? We are getting this type of structure, this compound. Both the compounds are same. Why? Because we have taken the symmetrical ketone. This cyclopropane ring that is formed is symmetrical in nature. So we can break any of the bond in this case. But this cannot happen in the case of the unsymmetrical ketones. Suppose we are taking this ketone C6H5CH2, C double bond O, CH2Cl. Okay? We are taking this ketone, and when it is treated with the OR minus ion, then what will happen? There will be the abstraction of the proton from this alpha carbon atom, right? So we are getting here a carbanion in this way, right? Now this will make an attack at this carbon atom. This will attack it in this way. And there will be the expulsion of this chlorine. So we are getting the cyclopropane ring in this way. This is C double bond O, and this was the carbon atom in this way. Okay, and there is a formation of this bond. This is the cyclopropane ring that we are getting now. Now there should be the breakage of the bond. So now when we treat it with the OR minus ion and then rupture the bond, what can happen here? There will be two conditions. One condition is that we are breaking this bond, okay? Another condition is that we are breaking this bond, okay? There are two conditions. Suppose we are breaking firstly this one bond, okay? When we are rupturing this bond, then we are getting here C6H5CH minus CH2COOR, alright? And when we are breaking the another bond, it means we are not breaking this bond. Now we are breaking this bond. Okay. So our ion will be here C6H5CHCOOR and this CH2 minus. Now we have to see the stability, relative stability of the carbon ions. And we know that this carbon ion is much more stable. Okay. So this will now convert to the product. We have to see the stability of the carbon ion, and then we are getting the major product. So this will be our major product, okay? Well, now we have to see some more examples. For example, see this compound. Same type of reaction is happening here. So I don't want to give you here the mechanism, because here there will be attack at this carbon atom. So this hydrogen will be abstracted, and then this carbon ion will attack at this carbon atom, okay? So there will be a bond formation between this carbon atom and this carbon atom. This chlorine will leave out, okay? So there will be a cyclopropane ring formation here, right? So now the ring will get contract. Here the ring is 6 membered, so now we have to make the 4 membered ring, okay? In this way. Just consider what is happening in the reaction. So you don't need every time the mechanism, okay? And now see here. In this case, we have given the HCl. It means there is happening the acid hydrolysis afterward. So now we are not getting the ester as the product. We are getting the acid as the product. So here this ester is now converted to this acid. So this will be our product. Now see this compound. Here we have to give the mechanism because this is somewhat different. So what is happening here? Firstly see, this base will abstract a proton from here. So we are getting here a carbanion in this way, right? Now this will attack at this carbon atom, okay? So this bromine will leave out, right? So what we are getting now? We are getting here a cyclopropane ring. This is the carbon atom of this ketone, okay? And this is our carbon atom and this is the carbon atom. In this way we are getting the ring. Now there will be the attack of ethoxide ion, because we have taken ETO as the second compound, so there will be attack of ethoxide ion. So what we are getting now? This will attack at this carbon atom. It will attack at this carbonyl carbon atom. So this bond will polarize in this manner, right? So now we are getting, we can make it in this way. This will be OET and this will be O minus. Now in the next step, there will be the breakage of the bond. It means this bond will now rupture. So here we are getting CH3 group and here we are getting COC2H5 group. So now our product will be in this way. This is CH3 and this will be COOET group. So this will be our product. Now see this example. This is also an example of cyclic alpha haloketones. This is the 8 membered ring. So now after the ring contraction, ring will be 7 membered, okay? So firstly we have to make here the 7 membered ring. This is 7 membered ring and now at this position we have to make the ester C double bond O OC2H5. So this will be our product here, okay? Now see this compound. This is somewhat different. When it is treated with alkoxide, what is happening? From here the hydrogen will be, the proton will be abstracted from here. So we are getting a carbanion here. Now this carbanion will attack at this carbon atom, okay? So this chlorine will leave out. So we are getting a cyclopropane ring here, right? So what will be our product? Here we will get CH3 and this will be COOCH3, okay? So this will be our product. Okay, now see the next example. When alpha alpha, it means GEM dihaloketones, or alpha alpha dis, it means vicinal dihaloketones are subjected to the Fabry-Russell rearrangement, then they gives the alpha beta unsaturated esters. In both the cases we are getting alpha beta unsaturated ester. We can see here the example. See here, in this compound both the bromines are attached to the same carbon atom, so it is an example of geminal dihaloketones. And when it is treated with the alkoxide ions, this will abstract the proton from here. This is the alpha carbon atom, okay? Now this carbon ion will attack at this carbon, so one of the bromine will leave out and we are getting a cyclopropane ring between these two carbon atoms, and then there will be the breakage of bond in the presence of OR minus ion. So what will be our product here? At this carbon atom there will be one bromine and one hydrogen, right? And this is the new bond between this carbon atom and this carbon atom, okay? And here is also one R group and one hydrogen, and this is the C double bond O. In this way we are getting the cyclopropane ring intermediate, okay? And now see, if we see this compound, in this compound one bromine is attached to this and another to this carbon atom. It means it is an example of vicinal dihaloketones. And in this case, when we are treating with the OR minus ion, then what happens here? Here also the hydrogen can be abstracted from here, or there is a condition it can be abstracted from here. both the hydrogens are same, so one hydrogen will be abstracted. If it is abstracted, then this carbon ion will attack at this position and this bromine will leave out. So same is happening here, we are getting the same type of compound. It means we are getting this product, same product we are getting here also, okay. And then this compound is treated with OR minus ion, so this will attack at this carbon atom, so it will go in this way, right. So what we are getting here in this way, here will be C O minus and OR, right, and here will be this CRH in this way. Now there will be the reversal of this charge in this way, okay. So this bond will rupture here, this will go in this way, okay, and this bromine will leave out. So what will be our final product here? This bromine will leave out, so here we are getting CH, and this will be now double bond, so we have to make here a double bond in this way, right. This is the carbon atom to which R and H are attached, okay, and this will be COOR group here. This is the COOR group, so this will be our product. Sometimes we see that the reaction becomes highly stereospecific. What is meant by stereospecific reaction? It means when one of the isomer is giving the one product and another isomer is giving another one, then such type of reactions are known as stereospecific reaction. For example, consider these two molecules. Both the molecules are same, but there is a difference in the stereochemistry at this carbon atom. You can see here, okay, here this chlorine is at the axial position and here this is at the equatorial position, okay. So in both the cases we are getting the different product. Here the hydrogen will be abstracted from here and here a ring is formed, while here the hydrogen will be abstracted from this position and we are getting a ring in this way, okay. So ultimately in this case, what will be our product? We have to see here the products, what is happening here. So in this case, this is the CH3, so now this will be at the equatorial position and this ester group will be at the axial position, right. So this is the one isomer, and in this case you can see here this is at the axial position. So now this CH3 will be at the axial position and this ester group will be at the equatorial position. It means two different isomers are giving the product with two different isomers. One is giving one isomer and another one is giving another isomer. So such type of reactions are known as stereospecific reactions. Alright, now we see the quasi-Favorsky rearrangement. In the case of the alpha haloketones, when there is no alpha hydrogen on the other side of the carbonyl group, in that case also we are getting the product same as that is found in the case of Favorsky rearrangement. So such type of reactions are known as quasi-Favorsky rearrangement. For example, consider this example. Here this is the carbonyl group and at the alpha position there is chlorine, so it is an example of alpha haloketone. But see here, this is the vinyl group. It means there is no alpha hydrogen present at this position to be abstracted by this base, so there is no hydrogen to be abstracted, right. But this will also undergo the Favorsky type of rearrangement. It means it is giving the same product as we are seeing in the case of Favorsky rearrangement. What we are getting here in this way, we are getting this pH and this is COOH. This is our product that we are getting here, right. The product is very much similar, but here the mechanism is not of the cyclopropane ring. This mechanism does not happen by the transient cyclopropane ring. Actually this is the mechanism somewhat similar to semi-benzylic rearrangement. So this example is of quasi-Favorsky rearrangement. If you have given such type of examples in the exam, then always remember that this is quasi-Favorsky rearrangement, okay. So this is all about the Favorsky rearrangement and quasi-Favorsky rearrangement. Meet you in the next video. Thank you.